Okay, cue the width tool. So we're going to go ahead and click on the width tool over here. Shortcut is W. So I've clicked on that, and now I will select the curve that I want to add it to. So I'll select this top one again. Basically, we can just add a point in the middle to start off with. So I'll just add a point there, and you can see it's been added, and there's some little handles there. I can click and drag these in and out. And if we look in the context toolbar at the options available to us, the first two are this, lock line weight. So that is on right now. So if you look, if I drag in and out, I can't drag out further than that because it's locked the line weight to whatever the width was in the stroke panel. So what I can do is uncheck that, and then I can go ahead and bring it out as far as I want. But I think it looked a little bit better before, so I'm just going to press Command Z. I'll lock that again. What's the next option? Lock point ordering. So let me add another couple of points. So I'll add a couple there. So we've got three in a line now. So as that one is already selected, lock point ordering, I will drag this one over here. And look, it doesn't let me go past this point here because I've locked the point ordering. And it also doesn't allow me to go further out because I also have line weight locked as well. Okay, what are the other ones? Snap to curve nodes. So when I click on this one, you'll see just there, there's a little white dot. If I go back to my node tool, you can see there's one node there, and one node there. If I just add a couple more, just so it's more obvious, I'll go back on the width tool, and now you can see those little dots there. Basically, this snapping option, snap to curve nodes, allows us to drag these widths that we included, and when we go past the node, it allows us to just snap to that node, and that's pretty neat. Okay, so the last option is under snapping, snap to widths on same curve. So if I select that one as well, and let's say I uncheck lock line weight, I'm going to drag this out really far, and I'm going to add another width here, and I'm going to drag that out really far as well. When I get to a certain point, it will snap to the same width as this one. So this one is the thickest one on the line. And as I drag it out, you can see it kind of changes. I'll zoom in post-production for you. So that is snapping to that weight. If I had, let's say this one here, if I drag this out and then drag it back in again, it's snapping and it's showing in purple the ones that it's similar to in width. So that's what all of those options do. But let's just make it look okay, shall we? I will lock the line weight here. I'm going to bring this down and I'm going to bring this side down as well. And you know what? This one here, I no longer need anymore. So I'm just going to double click it and then I can get rid of the width point. I can move this up and down to get the smooth look. Okay, so I think that's done. A lot more control with the width tool. Okay, let's go down to the wave and see what we can do with this one. So I'm still in the width tool. I'm going to click on it once. And now I'm going to go up to our options. I'm going to lock the line weight because I don't want it to get thicker than that. I'm going to click on snap to curve nodes. Just so I can see the actual nodes of the curve I drew. So I'm going to start adding my width points now. So I think I'm going to add one around here. And I'm going to add one around here as well. And up here, I'll just add one to this kind of top part here. So I can start dragging that in because I want this bit to be the thinnest part, this sharp corner here. And as the wave comes out, it gets thicker. And let's say I wanted it to be a lot thinner here. Maybe I'll just place it around there and drag that in. Okay, that's looking okay. There are some artifacts going on here, so I can try and fix that by adding another point. There we go, I fixed it. And zooming out, what else do I want to do? I want to try and make this the same size as that side. So I'm going to go up to my options again. And I'm going to do snap to widths on same curve. So I'm going to select that one and I'm going to go ahead and click on this. And you see it's snapping down. And it's purple, and you can see on the right hand side that is also purple, so that is equal. So I could just leave it at that, and the width tool did a pretty good job. So definitely use this width tool when you're using the pen tool or even the pencil tool. So far with both of these objects, we have applied the pressure profile on it, and we saw how that affected the pressure profile graph, and also we went on to use the width tool. This is the one that we've used with the width tool. So if I just select the top one, you can see that has also created a pressure profile for that and the wave. So this would be the pressure profile for the wave that we created with the width tool. So technically, they're just doing the same thing, but there's just different ways of going about it.